Hi, Rabbi Glass here, coming to you from a deserted Tribeca in front of the beautiful Tribeca Synagogue, which for now is empty, but we hope will be open soon for prayer and Torah study. But for now, let's talk about the Parsha. Actually, it's again a double portion, Acharei Mos-Kedoshim. And as the name would indicate, Kedoshim deals with the subject of holiness. Previously, we were discussing holiness in the realm of bodily purity, like dietary laws, relations between the sexes. But now we discuss the topic of holiness in the realm of interpersonal relationships. And the crown jewel of that area is what we call in secular society the golden rule, but in Hebrew, it's v'ahavta l'reacha kamocha, love your neighbor as yourself. How do we understand such a grandiose concept? Well, let's look to the Talmud, which shares with us that famous parable of the Roman soldier who approaches our two great luminaries, Shammai and Hillel, with the unusual request to be converted on condition that they're able to teach him the entire Torah while standing on one foot. Shammai, his response is rather curt. You can't get there, and just pushes him out of his presence. Hillel, on the other hand, invites him in with the famous words, "That which is hateful to yourself, do not do to your friend." What was their difference of opinion? Well, they had two different approaches to human nature. Shammai felt that if you sugarcoated it, if you didn't make sure that that prospective candidate understood the distance of the journey to Torah and good deeds, then they would never get there. On the other hand, Hillel felt that no one would be motivated that way, and that, on the contrary, you had to show them how short the journey was. This is all you have to do. So get the process started, and you'll get there eventually. The question, though, that I had when I asked my great mentor, Rav Shraga Moshe Kalmanovich, the Rosh Hashiva of the Mir Yeshiva, I said, why did Hillel express this great concept in a negative fashion? Do not do. What is missing with love your neighbor as yourself? He said to me something very, very profound. He said that if you're beginning this journey, something that's so wide, like love, your neighbor, etc., it's too abstract. You have to put things in a manner that everybody understands. Everybody understands what is uncomfortable, what is painful. So it's a very simple extension to take that which in your experience is unpleasant and avoid ever doing that to your fellow Jew. Shabbat Shalom.